Hi everyone, my name is Soodabeh and I'm a freelance illustrator. Welcome back to another Vectornator tutorial. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to draw a vector leaf from start to finish. Leaves are relatively easy to draw since you don't need to think too much about proportions while sketching. So let's jump straight in and have fun in the process. The first step is to do research and get inspired. I usually browse Pinterest to find inspirational photos and study my topic before I start drawing. So here I found some photos of my favorite leaves that I'm going to use as a reference. But of course, you can use real plants to get inspired as well. Next, I am going to create some sketches from my references in order to get familiar with the shape of leaves. Try to be analytical here and find the basic shapes that form your main object. For example, this leaf has a circular shape, while this one is more edgy. And this one is made up of two triangles joined together. The more you look at an object, the better you can visualize it from different angles. Keep in mind that your sketches don't have to be perfect, as they aren't the final artworks. We are going to refine them in Vectornator. I think the easiest view to draw a leaf in is by viewing it straight on. And if you are a beginner, I suggest you start drawing in this view and then moving on to other angles. As you see, most leaves have a beautiful symmetrical shape. So start off by drawing a line in the center and then drawing identical shapes on both sides. This will make your life easier. Some leaves have carriages while others are sharp. But in most cases, no edges are perfectly straight or rounded. Try moving your hand from side to side to make your drawing more realistic. After you've mastered the straight-on view, you can start to draw the leaves from other angles as well, or even cluster them together to make an entire plant like this one. Once you are happy with your sketches and studies, go ahead and pick the one that suits your project best to vectorize in Vectornator. The first step after opening Vectornator is to create a new canvas. The size is totally up to you, but I usually use my device size as it easily fits my screen. And of course, with vector illustrations, you can always change the size without losing quality. Now that you opened your canvas, the next step is to import your sketch into a new layer. And then just lower the opacity in a way that you can barely see your sketch. Then go to the Style tab and change the blend mode from Normal to Multiply. After that, create another layer beneath your sketch where you are going to create your vector art. So basically, everything you draw is going to be underneath your transparent layer. The next thing you should consider is the color palette. I think it's important to think about the colors before even starting your illustration. Of course, you can change it whenever you want, but I think it's much easier to have them in mind in advance. I usually use the pen tool, but in some cases, other tools might serve you better, like the shape, pencil, or brush tool. For tracing this particular leaf, I am going to start by drawing a circle with the shape tool. Then I'll draw a line with the brush tool filled with a darker color to act as the leaf stalk. And I'll also add similar yet thinner lines on the leaf itself. Now that we have this shape, it's time to add some dimensions by adding shadows. You just need to duplicate your entire shape. Move the duplicate and then just apply the subtract boolean operation so we are left with the shadow shape. Finally, darken up the color and we are done. Since this was so easy, let's level up the complexity and draw another leaf that's a little bit more complicated, like this Monstera elbow leaf. It's one of my favorite plants. It's essentially similar to our previous plant, but instead of being round, it has a heart shape. So to draw it, I'm going to start with a reversed heart shape, which I create with the pen tool by drawing half of the shape. Then make a copy of that, flip it, and unite these two shapes to have a perfect heart. Now, to give it its Monstera look, I create all these circles and curves on top that I then subtract from the leaf with the same Boolean operation we used before. Finally, I add the veins and shadows to make it pop, the exact same way I did for the other leaf. All done. I hope you guys were able to follow along. If you have any tutorial requests, please write them in the comment section down below. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and I'll see you soon with a new tutorial. Bye!